there's no person in the world to me like Pastor Pam. That is a precious, beautiful lady. All the ladies, let's make some real good noise for Pastor Pam. Such a good example. One of those wonderful years we got a chance to spend together throughout the 30, within the 30, was one of the times I came to celebrate the Queen of Clean. And so I don't think I'm stepping outside my bounds to say, you already know the red cap is coming at some point. That when that red bell cap gets there, it's time to clean. There is an incredible man in the midst. Of course, I have to honor them both. He's a band man. He can sing, he can preach, he can dance, he can do whatever. The bishop, the one and only Daryl Hines. Just says that you all know what you were doing.
Yes.
There are some who have gone 10 years and look twice your age. Yeah. Right. And some just didn't make it. Millions didn't make it. There are a couple who have. And, I saw a DJ, he came upstairs a few minutes ago. And I said, you realize you've turned into your dad? And as soon as I saw him, I said, that's it, you're your dad now. And what a good person to be. And you have a really strong name to hold, and I'm sure you honor that. We honor God for you. I love singing, and I like singing around people who understand singing, because I'm a kind of different kind of singer, you know? And everybody doesn't always get my sound, but Bishop Daryl and Pastor Pam, they do. So I feel comfortable. Let's do what we do. Whichever one you play, I know all of them.
real love to that part. You like I know. Go to that part. Okay. And just rock and roll. So, here's what I think about. Every time I land in a plane, I feel like singing that. You don't know like I know. Anybody have a you don't know like I know story? Real nice, sir. You don't know. That's good. And so, 30 years? How many leaders do we have in the room? You do something in church that people expect you to do and do it well. I show them. Okay. So, I'm sure you've had some meetings and you walked out of those meetings feeling like, and it gets hard sometimes, doesn't it? Have you ever been in a position that you walked out of the meeting saying, what have I gotten myself into? And you're only 1 year deep. Imagine 30 years. Give me a little heart with that foot on the drum. Everybody say, yeah.
About God, thinking about God, what a charge you have given me.
break out singing, especially if you're born and raised in Church of God in Christ, you just make up a song. I remember growing up, my dad would call home and say, the house is clean, we're going to Red Lobster. And back then, Red Lobster was the deal. And I don't mean to make anybody mad, but some of you, it's still the deal. Hey, here's to your cheddar butter biscuits, whatever you like. But back then, when you said Red Lobster, you were talking about top of the line. Are you kidding me? And so daddy called, y'all clean up the house. We're going to Red Lobster. Immediately, all four of us, oh, red, red lobster. Oh, red, red lobster. Oh, red, red lobster. We're going if the house is clean. Oh, red, red lobster. We have music in our bones. And so when you're church, it happens like that. But when you're saved, you have different songs. Anybody, those car singers, you will never hear your voice in church because you don't trust your gift like that. But if the car could tell the story, we get quite a story. And I just heard this song just now. Because this means so much more to me, just as it means to your leaders. If some of you tell the truth, you already know some things you've said or done or didn't do that you don't deserve to really have the role you have. But your leaders see so much more in you and say, keep going until you get it right. I brought that up because this whole moment of I surrender all, I want to help somebody in this room. Just let it go, will you? Surrender everything to God. We're not just talking about salvation, but just say, okay, hands up. My life is not ruled by me. It's by God and God alone. So let me help you so you won't continue in 2019 as if you own the year. This is all about God. All to Jesus. For your kids. Surrender all for your spouse. To him I freely give. Oh, I will ever love and trust him in his presence. I will dare. I surrender all. Tell somebody, I'm going to sleep tonight. My beloved Jesus. Will you lift your hand? Somebody's on your roll that needs this. There's something about His name. Some call Him Master. Say, oh, healer, provider, mind regulator, strength giver, lover of our souls, the one who picks up all the pieces, makes us whole again, doesn't have to get permission from anyone to bless us, forgives us and remembers it no more.
Somebody!
you here, especially right over there. God's doing it for us. Praise God, amen. Let's sing about this. He's everything. Some call him Master, Savior, Jesus. Some call him the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Do you still have some worship in you tonight? Come on, let's worship God. Come on, let's go there. Glory to God. Receive it. Receive it. Please receive it. It's yours. Glory to God. My God. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Will somebody just let out a praise, some kind of praise? Hallelujah. Come on, let me hear you. Come on, we honor you, Lord. Thank you.
Yeah!
good? I have a confession. Can I give it? All right. Hopefully my secret will be safe with you and all those taping. You know, growing up in Church of God in Christ, you just learn how to do a certain kind of thing a certain kind of way, right? But when y'all came together that one time, two times, five, 20 times a year, you found out you had so many things in common. You know, like, yeah. We know what's next. Yeah. Right. And stuff like, I'm a soldier in the army of God. Right. So we all had a code. In all the different keys, y'all just sang it in. God bless. God bless. I mean that. And so, I was growing up in church, and I used to love to hear Mahalia Jackson sing. I'm sorry, it's really not going to be that good after this, about that. Not to kill your dreams, you know. But I love Mahalia even more once I saw documentaries of her. Stories, powerful. And growing up, you had, in my era, James Cleveland was the thing. And Mahalia and Albert E. Walker Caravans. And we just all the Clark sisters. Don't get me wrong. Hawkins. Wildings. All the good stuff. Everything. All the good stuff. But when I started singing, I didn't feel like I sounded like any of them. So I used to ask my parents, I said, am I saved? Because when I listen to James Cleveland, it scares me at night, you know, because he had this song, Still on the Banks of Jordan, and on the recording you hear somebody in the audience and he's just screaming, and that used to bother me, you know, because I was trying to listen to gospel music to go to sleep before going to school, and what started out as, you know, a privilege to do so, I ended up pulling the covers over my head because I was scared. I was like, if this is gospel, I don't want it, you know? And then I heard the Hawkins, and I'm going away. I know. And so, so when Walter died, man, I just, my heart broke. I'm like, man, we're losing the era. Daryl Coley's, you know, heartbreaks. Real music, you know, real gospel music. Now, you know, it's a lot different. I'll just leave it like that. So I listen to a lot of jazz and, you know, music with no words. Just to kind of keep my mind at peace at times. But the point I'm trying to make is the moment that I just had with this incredible guitar player is what I always wanted to do in church. Musicians were just afraid to play with me, and at the time I didn't understand it. Over time, I've tried to embrace whatever their truth is. So you're hard to follow. You do a lot of stuff. And I'm like, I'm not singing anything that's not on the keys. You can find it, my friend. from the way you're playing, there was a way that seemed right. So I've had to deal with a lot of challenges in my music career. And I remember doing, preparing to walk out to do Yankee Stadium, as I mentioned before. And Harry Connick Jr., you remember him? Harry Connick Jr. invited me to do that with him. And I asked him right before we walked out, we were standing in a dugout, surrounded by the mafia. Okay, next story. It was Catholics, okay. And so he says, you ready? I said, yeah. I said, hey, Harry, why me? Why did you choose me to do this? You know, Harry said to me, he said, because you know what, Kim? It's like I'm the Jeep that goes and rough up all the land, but you're the Cadillac that makes it ride smooth, you know? And I said, ain't nobody in church ever told me that. He navigated my whole life, you know? I said, about the splinters I received from playing the organ. And but I decided to not succumb to what I felt I didn't get from the church. And why? Because I always knew it was here. It's always been here. And it's just a matter of time. So to those of you who feel like the gift you have doesn't belong in the church, it does. It's just a season and a time for it. It's gonna happen, okay? Speaking of that. Okay, this one is for Bishop and my sweet lady Pam. I wrote this song when I was 14 years old. Never mind how long ago that was. They say, you already said you've been singing for 30 years. Well, I was an infant. It's the first song I wrote. Come on, sing it, man. Oh! said, I have to go back and look at videos of me. That's when you do it out of yourself. I go back and I listen and I watch and I go, only God could do that. You know why I say that? It's not an arrogant statement, it's not pride. It is because from the ages of 6 to 14, they sent me home to die every year. Double pneumonia, lungs collapse, we can do no more. Fever 106, 100, and talking out of my mind. They said I would have brain damage. Some of my family members think that it really happened. But I'm bouncing back every day. But God spared my life for that. And when you come through that, how do you be puffed up? How do you get caught up in yourself? So I'm so grateful. I'd like to sing this and dedicate this to these beautiful leaders who I love now and forever. Let me hear that. All right, it's gonna be, from Acapulco. It's acapella, church version. I could never do this as good as you, Jonathan. I'm not even trying. And they're laughing. I could teach you some things. I'm going with my new hat. Let me adjust it. Okay. Okay, here we go. For the sake of the saints, I do keep my dress down, though. Okay, all right. Take my red nose off. Okay, so my mother used to sing this. Let me hear it again. I am satisfied.
Bless you.
Is my master satisfied with me? I sing that as a question to the Father for my brother and my sister. And the answer to that question after 30 years is yes.